Hello guys, good afternoon. I am Kundan Kumar, your mentor. Today we are going to learn about Google Map API. The topics to be covered in these sessions are understand the API, understand the Google Map API, how to create a Google Map API for Android app, Google Map demo app, and case studies. So what is the API? API stands for Application Programming Interface. Definition of API could be an application programming interface is a computing interface to a software component or a system that defines how other components or system can be used. Fine, when look at this definition, it seems complex. Definition is very clear, but it seems complex. So let us understand in easy way what is the API. Actually, API is a program that helps us to connect two different applications seamlessly. Let me take an example and explain you. When you try to book online ticket using QatarAirways.com, EthiopianAirways.com, RwandaAir.com. So when you are booking a ticket online, at the end of the booking, you have to make a payment of the ticket. So don't you wonder how are you going to make a payment? Once you make a payment, the amount you have made a payment will be transferred to respective airlines from your bank account. So how it happens? It happens through the API. When you try to send the money from Momo, how it happens? Through the API. When you try to send money from your country to another country using a Western Union money transfer, how it happens? Through the API. Because API is a interface between two different parties. Hope I made you clear. Next, understand the Google API. Google offers a different kind of API. Few are here called the Google Map API, Google Traffic API, Google Login API. You would have seen in different kind of an application that Google, the system asks you to log in through the Facebook, logging through the Google, logging through the Twitter, logging through the Facebook. So like that, you can also develop an application that system can ask login through the Gmail or Google API. So like that, if you want to integrate a map, Google Map on your Android application, how to do that? So we can use the Google Map API. Let us see the family of Google Map API. You can see we have a map, we have a routes, and we have a places. So these are different family that can be integrated in your application. It depends on your requirements. Let us go how to integrate Google Map in Android application. So I have written down in the different phases. So to integrate a Google Map in your Android application, you have to open Android Studio IDE first. Then you need to create a new project. Then give the name of the application or project. Then we need to choose the Google Map activity from activity templates. Then let the project open, because it will take time to open your project. Once the project is open, the two files will be created, mapsactivity.java and googlemapsapi.xml. One is this. So we have to make a modification in this one, because we need to create a Google API key through this console.developer.google.com platform. Then we need to copy the API key, and then we need to paste on this file, Google Map API.xml file. Then we need to change the latitude and longitude of your city in this file maps activity.java, and then we run the system. Let's see how it had happened. So you have to open the Android Studio ID. So I'm going to also open. So once you open, you will click to create a new project using this button here. Then you'll, once you click on that, you will, the new window will be open. They will ask you to write the application name. We are going to write application name. Once you write application name, then they will ask you to choose your an activity. Since we are going to create a Google Map application, so we are going to choose Google Maps activity from the given template. So I will select this one that I have rounded with the red color. So then you click next. Once you click the next, your project will be ready like this. So once you create this project, you can see two files has been created. One is Maps activity, one is Google Maps api.xml. Look at this one. They have given this comment. You can read this comment. This is for you. This is called the internal documentation. So they are asking us to go to this website and create a Google Map API. Create a Google Map API. We need to create a Google Map API. Once you create a Google Map API, we need to come and paste and this location your created API. So how do that? How do to create a Google Map API? So I'm going to copy this address, copy, open the web browser, paste on the web browser and go. System may take time. Okay, one more thing. When you are going to open the console.developer.google.com, you need to log in. If you have not logged in, you cannot create. So you have to log in first using your Gmail account, and then they will offer you to create a new project on to for the you're creating a Google Map API. So far I have created many project on this Google Map API. So you can see I have a many project. I'm going to click. I have a many project here. You can see when I click on this, I have many projects I have done. So what I can suggest to you, you can click on this, then go and create a project, new project. The system will ask you to create a new project. You can give the new project name here. You can give the project name that whatever name you want to give here, like a Google Map demo or anything that you want to give it here. So I'm not going to go because I have already created. You can see I have written, you have only two projects remaining in your quota. So I'm not going to create, I have already created, so I will use that one, okay? So once you create, then you follow what I'm going to do. So I'm going to do this one. So since I have already created this project, you can see my Google Map demo, this is for this sessions I have created. So I'm going to select it, I'm going to credentials. I create a credentials. I will find my API key here. You can see API keys are here. So once you create a Google API project, it will be not ready. When you come to the credential, they will ask you to create. It will be an empty. So you have to create, then you have to copy. So since I have already created Google project, I have already created Google API key, so it's available. So I'm going to copy clicking on this. So I copied this. Then I'm going to my project. Locate this file. Can you see the where I am under the res? Under the value Google Maps API.xml. This file was automatically created when you are creating the project. So you can see they're asking your API key. So I'm going to Control V. I can say I'm going to paste it. So I'm going to paste the key. You can see it is there. So I have pasted the key. Now next is, so I have done this job. You can see I have done this. You can see I have given in the slideshow. So I have done this. Let us go and change. I have pasted this. You can see I have pasted. I have already given the screenshot on your PowerPoint for your understanding. So let us go and change the latitude and longitude in maps activity.java. So how to do that? So let us go maps. Can you see this is a maps.activity? Go there. I'm going to do it. So this is a place where you can see this is a by default is there. So which activity you want to change? So I can say how to know your city latitude and longitude. So how to know? So to know your city latitude and longitude, you can visit www.latlong.net or www.google.com/maps. Okay, so you can visit. Let me try to do this one for me. Go open the Google. I'm going to paste it here. I'm clicking. See, it is open. You can open even the www.googlemaps.com. So I'm going to pause here. It is still loading. So when you will pass here, you can pass here Kigali. I have done. When you click on the find, system is giving the error. So let me refresh it. You can open the Google map. You can type here Kigali. Then system will give you the latitude and longitude. You can copy from there. You can use it. So let me close it just for save the time. Okay. So I can also do the same here. You can go the Kigali. System will put you here. Let me try once again if it is work. No, still. So please ignore it. You can work it on this. So I remember the longitude and latitude of the Kigali. So let me go there and see. So this is the one I have already pasted here. This is a location of the latitude of the Kigali, and this is the longitude of the Kigali. This is already. When you create a new project, it will be for the Sydney. So I'm going to change the latitude and longitude object, so I can write Kigali. So I have to make a changes here. You can see this is an instance of latitude and longitude. So I'm writing Kigali. You can change, you can leave it Sydney, but it's better to write because you have changed the longitude and latitude. So let the users know what is that. Then you are going to put it there like a Kigali. Done. So fine. So you can see that if you want to know what is the use of this code and what is the use of this, you can see here. So this code that I have selected, line number 27, this code will help you to integrate your map, Google map, on launch of activity. One, this will bring the Google map on activity that you are running on the screen. Then on the ready of this map, this method will be called automatically. That's called the on map ready. Once map is loaded, the system will tell you it's loaded, and they will locate you. They will locate this marker in the Sydney at this latitude and this longitude. Okay, if you want to make a zoomable map, you can use it zoom, if I'm not wrong. Zoom, move camera, zoom, not working. Let me check it out. Move camera. Okay, I leave you for your research. Here you can try to find how to do it. I can make it here or something here. Let me try here. No, so I will leave you here. You can try. So this is done. Now you need to run this application on the mobile to see what happens. So once you run this application, you click on the run, connect your device. You can see you can use the virtual device or you can use your real device on the I'm going to connect. So virtual device is not coming. I have already connected. It may take time. Let me connect again, run again and check it. Let me check. Okay. Okay. Okay, you can see it's coming on my telephone. So I will go and click the run. Once you click the run, I'm not going to run just to save the time. So you will find on the screen this kind of output is coming. You can see the located in the Kigali on your telephone. Okay, so next, what is the next? So next, adding option menu for changing Google Map tag. What is the options? So what I mean to say, if you want to change the options, you can see on your Google Map, if I am not clicked here, Google Map, I'm going to see, okay, come on. So you can see we have a Google Map here. Let me click on this. So please, see, you can see the Google Map is loading. When I click on this option button, I can see the different kind of map. So it's taking time. Okay, now see, when I click on this side, please come on. Please. Okay, let me search first Kigali. This is not app. I'm using the Google Map to explain you what different kind of Google Maps are available. So that's my purpose to open this Google Map. Same thing can be done on our application that we are developing. Okay, so you can see we have a satellite type. So I'm going to click here. You can see satellite, terrain, normal. So by default is normal. Or we can see something, so we can change this one. We can change this one. The outlook will change. So that is what I'm talking about. Okay. So let me go and to the project. What we are going to do. So slideshow. So I'm going to do this one. What to do? So we are going to first to add the types of Google Map in your Android project. We have to create a resource directory called menu under RES folder of your project. So let me do how to do that one. So what is it? Create a resource directory called menu under resource. So I'm going to create, this is a resource. So I'm going to create a resource directory. So right click, new, sample, resource, see, Android resource directory, not sample directory, resource directory. So click this one. I'm going to name the directory called the menu, that is a, and then resource type should be a menu as well. So check it out, resource type should be menu, then click OK. You can see it is created here. You can see it is created here. Now, second step, they say create resource file called map options. Map option is a user defined name. You can give any name that you want to give or you wish to give under menu of race folder. Okay, so I'm going to create a here resource file menu resource file, not a directory, menu resource file. So I'm going to create menu resource files. So I'm going to give the name called the map option. Okay, that's it. No change, anything's created. You can see it has been created. System is taking time to load the preview. Okay, you can find the preview. So you can see I have a two files here, not this one, sorry. I can go to text design. See, you can see the bottom. So design text, so I'm going to text to create a file. So menu item. So I'm going to add a menu item. To add the menu item, we need to do some things here. You can see on the screen, you can follow. So I'm going to write app, because already Android is there, equal to https. Okay, we are going to select this one, up to rest auto. Okay, done. We have to add, then we are going to create a item. So item is a tag item. Then they are talking about, because each item should have ID, so I'm going to create an ID. I'm giving each ID. So at the ID, how to give the ID name? So we, as I know that we have a different kind of different type of let me comment here and talk to here. So we have a different type of Google map. So I'm going to use that name as a, so we have a types of Google map. This is just comment for you. So we have a first called the normal type. Okay, normal type we have. Second, we have a satellite type. Okay, third one we have a, we can say hybrid type. Okay, then we can say fourth one called the terrain type. Okay, so these are, so this is a name, I know it. So today also you go, came to know. So let me use the normal type. It's good. Okay, now we can give the title. So what titles you want to push it? Okay, so how it looks, so we can put it here like a anything's like a string app. So I'm writing here normal type. I'm using the string because if this string is nothing but this one, you can see that your string is not clear for this name, for this name. So that's why error is coming. I will fix how error at the last. This string means this folder. In this folder you have created the name. So what is the beauty of this string? Because when you create a big project and you want to refactor the name of the application, name of the anything, better to put, use the string name, and once you put change there, it will reflect to whole system. So that's the beauty of this string variable file. So now I'm going to use the app, show action, never, then I close it. So same thing we can do, we can copy paste. Okay, we can copy paste how many times? 4 times. So 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, it's become 5 types. Okay, so let me delete. Okay, I'm deleting. So now we need to change. So I'm going to change, because in the same file, two ID cannot have the same name. So I'm going to change the satellite type. Then I'm writing hybrid, this one, hybrid, this one, because according to type, you can write whatever name do you want to write, but better to write according to name of the Google map. That will be easy for us to understand. Hybrid, and then you put terrain. Okay, so now you can see this one is error is coming because your this at a string means this file. In this file, normal type is there. Let me open this file and see. The normal type is not there. So we can create like this string name normal type is a name of the string. We can say normal type. You can see the error would have gone. So this error is gone. Can you see the error is gone? Okay, at this level. So here I'm going to change the name also, because that was a string. Here we can say here also satellite type. We are going to give here as a hybrid type. Then we are going to give it here as a terrain type. Fine, you can see this error is there. I taught you how to create manually. Let me go this way, you'll find. So I'm going to select this one. I have taught already how to create using a string. So I can go here, I can type here, blah, 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 string and all. So let me tell you how to do easy way. So you can select the string to be created. So I'm going to select, go and select here, go to the red color, create a string, write the name what you want. So set a light. So give the resource name that will, that this is a name will appear on your screen. So give the start with the satellite type of space, because this is a string will display on your screen as a menu. So give the capital letter, that makes looks beautiful. So I'm going to see, you can change, they see you can becoming the error. No, sorry, the error is being removed automatically. So now I'm writing here hybrid type. Then I'm writing here, again select that file and create this one. Then I'm writing terrain type. Then click OK. And here you go. So you can see automatically all has been created. Okay. So we have created the option menu. That is, you can see this is options. Might be you can find in the preview. It's coming. See, you can see this coming. You can see the left hand side. It's coming here. All the, this is the way it will look on the your application when you run the application. Then you can change this, and wisely it will change. So question is that this is just menu you have created. How to make this menu effective? So once I click, what should happen? So we'll go to the step 3 and step 4. Step 3, they say, sorry, we have done this one. We have done just now this one. This is the one we were doing. So now we have to do a step 3, say, add on create option menu. Means we are going to override this menu. So this menu is going to inflate. If you will not add this program, your menu is not going to appear on your application, because this is a code. This code on create option menu will help us to inflate menu in your application. So let us go there and do it. So I'm going to where? Go to the main, as I have explained already where to go, in the maps activity.java file. So let us go maps activity.java file. Look at, see here, I'm going to do here. So I'm writing at override. You can select from there. Then I'm writing, okay, I'm writing here that public, this will return boolean type. So return, this is a Java method. So on create options is options menu. The parameter should be menu. Okay, menu opening closing. Fine. You can see there is error because this is a return type is a boolean and this function is method is not returning at anything. That's why. So it will go. So I'm going to add now menu. Okay. Menu inflator, because this menu inflator is going to help us to add the menu. So in menu inflator, this is, can you see this is a capital letter M and this is a small letter. This is a class. This one is a class. This menu, sorry, this one is a class and this one is object of this class. This one is object. So I have created new get menu inflator, close it. Then we are going to inflate on this object. So I'm writing here menu, a small letter, the instance, a small letter here, keep in mind. So inflate, what to inflate? The menu that you have created, you are going to inflate this menu we have created. This one, you can see the blue color on the screen, this menu. So how to do? So that's one. So we are going to do how to locate the resource. So R is means this folder. If I write R means this folder, red color, left hand side, right color. Okay, menu, what you want to from resource, from the menu. So I'm choosing the from the R dot, we can say menu done. In the menu, which one we have, we can have a many menu. Right now we have only one file in the menu. So I'm writing the map options, then next comma, then menu. This menu is nothing but this one, this object, that this formal parameter object. Fine. So we have added here. Now return true. You can see the error is gone. Sorry, a spelling mistake. True. Okay, error is gone. So this method will help you to add or inflate menu this item.
This internet connection isn't strong enough at the moment.
So menu item in your project maps activity dot, okay, maps activity. Fine. So menu has been added. It will be added like this one. Let me show you again. It will be added like this in when you run the application. This is a design mode. It will run, it will added like this one. It will added like this one. When you run the application, you'll find it. But when you click normal type, satellite type, you should change dynamically. So how to do that? So for that purpose, we are going to add another function that's called on screen, this one. So this will help us to change the Google Map types dynamically on your selections. Okay, so let us do how to do it. So I'm going to write again, override public, boolean, okay, on. Here is not creating, we are not creating. Creation is already done here. We have already inflated, we have created the menu on your activity. But now we are have options available. So we are going to make a selection. So we use the options, options, menu, options, item, because we have not menu, item. On options, item, selected. Okay. This need not menu, this need a menu item. Because what is the menu item? I can show you. These are a menus, sorry. These are a menus, but these are a menu item. Okay, these are a menu item. So I'm using that one. So menu item. Okay. So I can seal here. Okay. Menu item is small. This is a class. This is object. I'm going to open. Okay. So when you click on this, this will add your, this code will going to add the menu item in your activity. Once you select an activity, so this on option selection activity, this function will call automatically. So when you select any menu item from the list, this the selection will come automatically in this object. So we are going to identify. So I'm going to, okay, change the map based on the user selection Google map type from given menu. How to do that? So we are going to use the switch case to check what have you selected. So I'm going to item dot get item ID. Okay, so this menu is nothing but this is object. So this is a menu item bringing the item ID. So we are going to try to get which item you have selected. So we are checking that one in the switch case. You know, it is a conditional statement. We are going to check the condition, what you have done, you have learned in Java. So I'm checking case R is a resource dot ID dot what is the normal type. Why it's normal type? I'm going to show you. This is your Google map options. So this Google map options, you have a different options. So how would the Java code know that which item you have selected? So Java know all your user interface elements item using the ID. So what is the ID of the first one? You can see. What was the ID? It was a normal. For second one, it was a satellite. For third one, it was a hybrid. Fourth one, terrain. So I'm going to use this name. Okay, so that's the purpose. So it's coming. Normal type. Going down. Okay. Sorry. Okay. So. Okay. Now this is a syntax of the switch case. So I'm going to write. So once selection of normal type, we need to change the A map type. So how would know the A map is what? So it was not, I have not created. It was created by default when you are creating the object. You can see the Google map class. This is object. Can you see? This is the map object. So I'm using this object. I'm changing the Google map type here. Check it out. Google map type here. I'm changing. So on the selection of this one, I will keep changing. So a map is object dot set map type. Set map type. Look for set map type. It will come. You can make a selection. What map type? So we are using Google map is class dot m is a capital map. You can select from here which one you want. So since I'm making the normal type in the case, in this one here, case is a normal type. So I will choose the normal type wisely. So I'm going to choose the normal. Okay, once you send, then return, because each switch case statement should have a return type. Otherwise, all the flowing case will be running. So that's it. So we have to keep in mind. So let us go next. What is the next? Is called the satellite. So satellite type, that is ID of that I have showed you. Then again map, okay, m map is object. I have showed you this is object. You can see this is object I'm talking about. This one here. So this is the one I'm using, which was auto generated. Set map type, then we say Google map dot map satellite. So here onwards, what I'm going to do, I'm going to copy paste just for the save the time. So you also know. So I'm going to copy paste this one. Okay. Copy. I'm going to copy, then I'm going to paste here. It will save my time. So I'm going to choose here, because not same, because this third one is a hybrid. So hybrid type. Okay, I will change here also. It is not, if I will not change, it is not a mistake, it is a logical mistake. Okay, on the okay, that's it. So now again I'm going to paste another one. Again I'm going to paste, let me show you, paste. Then I'm going to change here, is what, call the terrain. Terrain type is there, you can see the terrain type is there, this one. You can see the terrain type is there. Now we have done it here. Let me see here. Okay, fine, we have done. So if you not change, see, this is a terrain type, and this is a still satellite type. So it is not a error, it is called the logical error. When you click hybrid, even click satellite, or you click terrain, the output will be same. That's why. So, but we need to change it here, so we can look for the terrain type. Okay, so now if none of things is selected, what will happen? So I'm going for add the default. So default could have a return super dot on option item selected is same the one you have bringing here, this one. Copy and paste it here, paste it here. Okay, we have done. You can see there is no errors in my project. You have seen. One more things I would like to inform you. You can, when I open the manifest, you can see this line has been added automatically. I have not added. So this is a permission that system have automatically added when you choose the Google Map activity. Okay, so you can read the comment. What is the comment? It is a purpose of this permission is very important. Okay, so now one is done. Let me check. All is well, all is well, all is well. So now I'm going to, so when I run the application, when run the application, the behind this, you can see here, it will be Google Map. On over the Google Map, you can find the three dot right hand side, on top right hand side, the three something like this, called the ellipse something. When you click on that, this menu will be appear, and then you click on the any item, then wisely the Google Map will be changing. So you have to again click the button, you have to select this, click on run. I'm not running, just trust me. So let me show you on the map. So once all is well, when you run the application, you can see these are a menu will be that I have rounded with the red circle. That will be there. So when you click hybrid, when you click satellite, the behind the Google Map will keep changing on your selection of items. Okay, fine. So this was a Google Map integration of Google Map API in your Android application with many types of Google Map that you can keep changing. Okay, so fine. There is a case study. You have seen how to integrate the Google Map. You locate your city on the Google Map. So there is another case study called the draw the route on Google Map. So might be called the source, might be called the source and destination. So if you want to draw the line from source to destination, how to draw? So still you have to use that line, that's called the polygon, polyline. So you, please, I leave this case study for you to explore more about this and try to find some code and try to develop some code and try to, once you develop, you can demonstrate me. Okay, thank you.